bring back old school stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
Did you know when they tried to, didn't they make a like a remake of that movie or something?
Did
and
they?
It's horrible? Or like a sequel?
Yeah, really good.
No, there's no need for it. You do not mess with a good thing.
No.
That is a classic.
Too big.
Yeah.
No.
Finishing up his interview right now. So, yeah.
Okay.
That was a good one. That was like when you watch on TBS when you're sick. At least I was.
I have a thing with like Vin Diesel movies when I'm sick. Like if they're on like Triple X.
Triple X.
Triple X, and then the first Fast and Furious.
First Fast and Furious.
It's just it's such a guilty pleasure. But when those get on the TV and I'm gonna have to do,
I
watch
it. It was like a space Warriors.
What do you think you need to know for
That's not going to be on during this, is it?
What?
We can hear whatever's going on.
CNN, SIFI.
That humming?
It's like, you can hear voices.
It's producer chatter. As well, in programming.
It's ours?
I think so.
Yeah.
I may plug that back in. Somebody.
Okay, one.
Stand in front of the camera.
I don't have my complete face on.
Oh, I thought that was him. Hey, go greet him in front of there, and then I'll shake your hand. All right.
Y'all ready to rock?
Yes, we are.
I sort of locked.
All right. Sounds good.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
Great. How are you?
Great. Thanks.
Pleased to meet you.
Nice
happy
belated
birthday.
Oh, thank you.
You got it.
Thank you. Is it Abby?
Yes, it's
Abby.
Yeah.
Nice to meet
nice
you.
To meet you.
I'll grab that. And let's see, you probably have a way that you dress this, and I have no idea how that works, but we'll see.
However you're comfortable.
And then
that may work out. Okay.
Find that behind your jacket.
Go.
Great, thank you.
Okay.
Now, just to let you know, Pink City does not usually have this weather in March, but
what?
It'd be
what?
Sure nice.
What? You're kidding.
If it could be changed so it would be that way all the time. It's beautiful.
There's something else. This is great. He's not taping yet, so.
Not yet.
Thank you.
I'll let you
can
know.
We restart the timer?
I haven't started.
Okay. Great.
Okay.
Right, he's ready.
What surprises you about this race for GOP nomination?
Well, it's been great to go across the country and meet a lot of wonderful people who started businesses and are doing their very best to get the economy going. It's also been surprising to see how many people are really hurting in the Obama economy. And I hear every day folks that are very, very upset with high gasoline prices, low wage growth, home values that are underwater. So I'm in this race to try and help people get this economy going again and to see higher wages.
Why do you think that the GOP nomination has not been crunched by you yet?
Well, the process for getting the nomination has been changed. We've actually adopted the kind of proportional awarding of delegates that has existed in the Democratic Party. And just like last time when you saw Barack Obama and Hillary Clinton go for months and months and months, our process will take a little longer, but I think you'll find I'll become the nominee in due time. And when that happens, we'll come together and focus on replacing President Obama.
Will it take until August?
I don't think it'll take that long. I think it's going to happen sometime sooner than that, but I can't give you an exact date.
Many of your opponents and some say that you are not a true conservative. So are you moderate, and is that a bad thing?
conservative businessman. I took the principles of fiscal conservatism to the state of Massachusetts and balanced the budget every year I was there without raising taxes. In fact, we cut taxes 19 different times. But you know, if you look at someone like Senator Santorum, let's look at his record. He voted to raise the debt ceiling 5 times without compensating cost cuts. He also voted to fund a Planned Parenthood. This is someone who voted in favor of stopping right-to-work laws. I have to tell you that I think he's made some real errors in terms of his judgment, and if you're looking for the fiscal conservative in this race, it's me.
What keeps you up at night?
There's not a lot that keeps me up at night. Now, to be honest with you, after a long day campaigning and going across the country and meeting a lot of people, when I finally get to bed at night, I'm ready to go right to sleep.
Nothing concerning you about the country, about the direction we're going, about the direction perhaps the race is going. Do any of those things kind of...
I was taking you too literally.
Yeah.
Worries and concerns, yeah. Of course. Mm-hmm. The great threats that America faces. An economy that has not rebooted as fast as it could have had we had the right leadership. National debt of $15.5 trillion, which can crush the coming generation. Iran about to become nuclear, and a president that was unable to prevent that from happening. We have some real challenges in this nation, and we need to have a president who understands how to get the job done, who's been a leader, and has had the experience of leadership. When the president was candidate Obama, some people said, you know, he's never run anything. What would it be like to choose a president who's never run a thing? Now we know him, and it's not a pretty picture.
Can one person control gas prices?
The policies of the president of the United States can impact prices of gasoline and can also impact how many dollars leave our economy and go to other people's economies. So if you want to get gasoline to be more moderately priced in this country and keep the dollars in the energy sector in the U.S., you have to do the opposite of what this president's done. You got to drill for oil in the Gulf, got to drill in Anwar, other parts of the Outer Continental Shelf also. You've also got to drill for gas, Marcellus Shale, get the gas out of North Dakota, use the resources we have in this country to be able to provide for ourselves and keep the money in the United States rather than going to, in some cases, unfriendly nations.
So the president can't control gas prices?
The president can have an impact on what happens to the price of gas and to oil, gasoline at the pump, and the security of the supply of those products, as well as the ability of the dollars that are associated with energy to stay in America.
And we mentioned it was your 65th birthday yesterday, and you don't plan on enrolling in Medicare. Why not, and what is your plan to overhaul the system?
Well, my plan for healthcare is to return the responsibility for the uninsured to states, get rid of Obamacare. The idea of the federal government imposing its will in all the states is simply unconstitutional and the wrong way to go. That's number one. Number two, for Medicare, for those that are currently on Medicare, it's not going to change. For people in their 20s and 30s and 40s, what you'll find is we'll have a premium support program where people can decide whether they want traditional Medicare or they want to get a private form of Medicare. And in that case, the dynamics of a marketplace and free people choosing their own course will do a better job, I believe, in keeping down cost than a single government-dominated healthcare system.
And that's why you chose not to enroll, or why did you choose not?
I have a health plan that includes coverage at this age. Maybe as I get older and my health plan expires, well, I will consider other alternatives.
Two shot?
I'm going to get a two shot.
Okay. Yeah, you bet. Thank you.
And so where do you head next?
I'm going to New York, actually, and do some fundraising in New York. And from there, I don't even know.
I'm sure a lot of your days are like that.
That's true. I know that over the weekend we'll be in Puerto Rico because there are delegates in Puerto Rico. We go where the delegates are, although I can't go everywhere the delegates are. Last weekend there were delegates in the Northern Mariana Islands and Guam. And they're a little far away.
Yeah.
So I sent my son. We picked up 18 delegates. So that was that's good. I think there's some delegates tonight in Samoa and in Hawaii as well.
Yes, there are in Hawaii. And I think we actually have Hawaii beat as far as weather goes. So I think you chose the right place.
Exactly.
I think so.
Here's Samoa.